Got a little public service announcement from your Uncle Trooper. If you're the kind of snowflake that gets tilted because I ride the boosted board in the street, you probably shouldn't be playing poker. Probably should go find like some fishing videos or maybe bowling. It's the Trooper, episode 3 of the... Before we hit the third poker room in the Trooper's 2022 Guide to Las Vegas Poker Rooms, I gotta make a quick sparkly pop drop. Drop one of two complete. Number two of two is a bit closer to where I'm gonna play the poker tonight, where episode 3 is gonna go down. Some guy in a car was like, look at this joker. Referring to me, of course. I'm like, I'm not a joker. I mean, I am wild. Ha, what? All right. Just drove to MGM Grand. This is the casino for today's guide to Las Vegas poker rooms. Sparkly Pop Drop Excalibur. This is another job for the boosted board. Oh, I'm telling them. You gotta go watch Shaft's vlogs. Because, because he's making Vegas vlogs. Yeah, are making Vegas vlogs.
Yeah, we just started it, put a couple up. They're rough, but we'll get better. Vegas Shaft and Angie.
Vegas Shaft and Angie.
Let us know what you don't like.
Yeah, let them know what you don't like.
Thanks again, Trooper.
All right, thanks. All right, made it back to MGM Grand. It is Saturday night. First of all, the MGM Grand Poker Room is open 24/7. Currently, there are 6-1-2 games. I think somewhat frequently they get 2-5 going here, but at night, probably on the weekends or whatever. I don't know if they'll have 2-5 tonight, play 1-2. On Bravo, it says $600 max buy-in, but it also says match the biggest stack. Buy-in. So I guess 600 is the most if you're starting a game or if no one has more than 600, they have some sort of rake back promotion going on right now. It's like a long-term thing for weeks. If you play a certain number of hours, you can cash out. You get paid a certain amount of money and you can cash out at certain tiers. The longer you go without cashing out, the more money per hour you can get. What does that do to the quality of the games at MGM Grand? Can't really say right now, nor will I really be able to say after playing one night here, but I would imagine it makes the games not so great. I mean, I thought locking your bike up was supposed to keep it safe. I have said before in this vlog, some promotions are essentially a way to take money out of the pocket of the tourists, put it into the pocket of local players. This type of promotion that they have at MGM right now, by the way, I'm pretty sure that's the only promotion they have going. This type of promotion is basically that, because you have to play a certain number of hours in order to cash anything out, okay? And even if you play here for only 2 hours, you are contributing to the promotion fund. So people who come here for the weekend or whatever and dump money into the promo fund stand pretty much no chance of getting any of it back. Everyone at the table contributes to the fund. Only people who play a certain number of hours, let me look at what the minimum number of hours is, 18. Of course, if you play 18, you get a certain rate of money back per hour. If you play 200 hours, you're gonna get more per hour. So still, it's a very local friendly, regular friendly promo. That's not to say you shouldn't play here if you're a tourist or whatever. I mean, they're taking $2 a hand out of the pot. So even if they had other like promotions, high hands and things like this, you still might not get anything back. By the way, as far as the parking goes, this is an MGM property. They definitely charge for parking unless you're Pearl or above. The rake at MGM is going to be $5 rake and $2 promo drop, promotional rake, whatever you want to call it. I don't know what you get for comps. I'll have to look into that. Those chicken fingers were not very good. Massively overpriced. I really wanted pizza, but the line was too damn long.
I thought you were retired.
Retired from playing?
No, from just working. This is starting to look like a job, if you ask me.
No, but this is fun.
All right, I should have changed tables tonight. The game I was in wasn't very good. However, it was very, very easy, so I just stayed in the game. Right now there are 8 1-2 games. There are still no 2-5 games, but I did find out that the comp rate, $2 an hour. There was one thing that was, I don't know what to call it. I mean, you could call it annoying. I don't know if annoying is really a fair way for me to describe it. There was just a lot of strategy talk at the table. The whole time I was there, I only played about 3 hours. Just like I told you before, before I even walked into the poker room, the room is gonna be full of grinders, right? Locals getting in the hours to cash in for the promotion. You know, it says now through June 2022. I don't know when the shit started. You know, It sounds asshole-ish when you hear horns like that, but I have to agree with the horn blowers in that situation. Blocking the intersection is like the worst thing you can do. I hate it. It's the worst thing. There's this funny thing about the promotion, though. There is a maximum number of dollars that they will pay out for the promotion overall. That number is $222,000. Once they pay out $222,000 for this promotion, promotion over, dead. Every day you can look on Bravo and see how much money is left to be paid out. As of today, $70,965. I mean, you know, you have a theoretical for every poker player, a theoretical for the rake, and a theoretical for the promo. I don't know what the exact number is, but let's just say 25 hands an hour, and let's say that somehow they miraculously pull the entire $2 per hand. That's $50 per hour going into the promo. If there are 9 players, then that would mean that each player is contributing $5.55 per hour. $5.56 per hour. Now, that was the same story. Guy blocking the intersection, except this time it wasn't a giant truck with a horn, it was a cop with a siren. Theoretically, to the promo drop. I mean, this is theoretically, right? So a lot of different shit can be the case. What is the point, Trooper? The point is that the room is jam-packed with locals who are just grinding out the promotion. Personally, if I was going to sit in the room and try to grind it out, I would probably shoot for like the 270 hours if I had started from the beginning. I don't know if I could mentally make it. I mean, sitting around with the same dudes day in and day out, talking strategy, using the word grind. I mean, generally speaking, I don't think you, especially in a 1-2 game, I don't think you want to sit down and, you know, talk about the fact that you're grinding or that you're playing professionally or any of that kind of stuff, just because I think it can sometimes make recreational players somewhat uncomfortable. And if a recreational player comes in and sits down, tries to play the game, maybe they are not, you know, super competent in the game, and they lose money. If they lose money in the other eight, if the guy loses money and the other 8 players at the table are grinding and talking strategy and talking about poker software and all this shit, you know, the entire time the guy sits there and loses his $300 buy-in, he's gonna have a different experience overall. He's gonna have a different taste in his mouth than, you know, than if he had sat down and the other 8 players are talking about hockey or basketball or, you know, the club or the craps game. That's just my opinion. I think it's a pretty valid opinion. I mean, I see the people who play in the games. I know that people feel intimidated when everyone else at the table, you know, is talking about that kind of stuff and they're just a guy. But hey, do whatever you want to do. I don't think I will be able to mentally sustain playing here for that many hours. So I end up winning $72. There were some super tight players in my game. A guy limped under the gun with pocket kings. I think he ended up winning like a $6 pot on the flop. But he said that the reason he didn't raise pre-flop was because he was out of position. You know, I have, I've told you before, my view on karma. Karma doesn't exist. Not the way that the majority of people think it does. I mean, if karma existed, then everyone would be rewarded for their good deeds, and everyone would be punished for their bad deeds in this life. I am referring to the karma that most people speak of. That just doesn't exist. Now, don't get me wrong. Sometimes people do good things and good things happen to them. Most of the time when good things happen to you, it's because you worked for it. And sometimes people do bad things or are extra bad people and bad things happen to them or things don't really seem to go their way. Tonight I was reminded of such a case of someone being a bad person and their lives not really being what it could be. Remember, if you like my videos, please do click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. And remember, even if karma doesn't exist, it does pay to be an honest person. I'll see you next time.